So what is the right way to remove duplicates from an array of numbers or strings? And what if that array in question contains objects? I will be talking about that in the video. Hi, my name is Roy Bogorny and I like to write JavaScript. I also like to read JavaScript and I like to talk about JavaScript. And in my weekly videos, I go through language concepts, I explain code, or I talk about the best practices like today. So if you are new, consider subscribing. I have seen this question many times on the internet. How do I remove duplicates? How to implement the unique function in JavaScript? And to be honest, a lot of the answers I've seen were a little bit outdated. So let me get it straight. If you have an array of numbers or strings, this is the way how to get duplicates off. This is the idiomatic solution. This is the correct solution. Let me go for that. You have the set, that's the important part, which you spread. We had a video about spread, I will link it here. If you don't like spread, you can use array from, it's equal and maybe like the more, it's okay. What is the important part here is the set structure. So set is the only structure in JavaScript that is built with uniqueness. It is the only structure that even knows what duplicates means, what uniqueness is. So I think that that's what you should be using when you deal with uniqueness. Also, because it is built in and it has been thought through, it is fast, it is small and readable, and it handles edge cases, because that's a problem I've seen with the other solutions, like most notably index of handles not a number, none, in a very wrong way, and it can like lead to some weird results. I would even argue that using anything else than this function should be explained. Like, I see it as something extra, something weird. So please, and maybe that's a good question for you. Is there a reason why you wouldn't use this? Do you know a use case when you would rather use some other solution? If yes, let me know in the comments, because I would like to really know about that. The array can contain something else than numbers or strings or primitives for which the set works perfectly, as I said. So if that's the case, you need to implement it yourself. I will quickly present two algorithms how to do that. So the first one is built on equality. You need to provide a function that says that two objects are equal. And equal can mean like shallow equality, it can mean deep equality, or it can maybe mean equality on certain attributes or certain properties. What then you do is that when you have this function, you can take the original array and filter it. And you do this trick that you only keep the candidates that are first items that are equal to themselves. It takes some time to think about it, but it's rather simple, it pretty works. The only downside is that you actually do a lot of computations, and if the is equal function is slow, this whole thing will be slow. The second algorithm can be much faster. It uses this notion of hash. Hash is some way how you represent an object using a primitive, usually a string. And again, it can be some complex hash function, or it can be simple thing like just taking the ID, or maybe taking the ID and date. When you have this function, what you basically do is that you go through all items, you compute their hash, and then you say, have I seen this hash? And if yes, you don't use this item. And if you haven't, you add it to a seen set and include this object. And again, as you see, I'm using set because it handles the unique values, in this case, hash. Great. Is that it? Yes, that's it. I believe that you should be using the language. So if you use it, if you use built-in objects, your code will be nice and it will be fast. Hey, thanks very much for watching. Definitely don't forget to subscribe to my channel. If you appreciate it, like this video. And let me know in the comments about the future videos you might want to see. My name is Roy Bogorny, and I like to talk JavaScript. See you next time.